What's up guys, it's Kelly and today I'm doing a nail polish 101 video. So this one's kind of, it's not a repeat, it's just I'm giving you more information. Like a while back, years ago, I did a video on how to do like a salon quality manicure at home, but I feel like I missed a lot of steps and I wanted to just do a nail polish 101 video, talk about every single step, give you guys all the info you need and just help you get started. Because I feel like a lot of times, especially when I'm doing my swatch and review videos, you guys are always like, I just don't understand how you paint your nails like that. So that's what this video is about. Let's get started. Okay, so tip number one, well, even before that, tip number zero is to remove whatever you have on your nails. If you have nail polish on your nails, if you have like little crusty pieces or whatever from your last manicure, you gotta remove that first. I have a video on removal and I know it seems like it's pretty obvious how to remove nail polish, but if you have dark colors or if you have colors that tend to stain, I feel like that will ruin your next manicure unless you take it off the right way. So I will link it in the cards, you guys can check that out. But yeah, just make sure you remove everything. Don't get it in your cuticles or mess up your hands or anything like that. And then you can move on to step number one. Actually, you can't move on to step number one yet because I forgot this part when I was filming the intro to this video, which is filing your nails. So I pretty much file my nails like once a week and I always like to do it right after I take off my last manicure. I always find that my nails get dull once they start growing out because I start to lose that sharpness of the square edges. So I will always just file them down. I have a whole video about how to file your nails square. I'll also link that in the cards. All right, so step number one is to moisturize. After you remove your nail polish, your skin probably has nail polish remover and or acetone on it, so it's gonna be dry and a little bit crusty. You wanna also moisturize your cuticles. And the reason that I do this before I start my manicure is because your cuticles could be like on your nail or growing onto your nail, or you could have pieces of dry skin on your nail bed. If you're painting over that, it's gonna be lumpy and bumpy and kind of gross. Very important to moisturize first. Make sure that your hands are totally clean and moist. And just push back those cuticles. You don't need to cut them. I am planning a video on just how in general I take care of my cuticles, so you guys can stay tuned for that. But yeah, you just want to make sure that your cuticles are nice and pushed back and you have a clean, clear nail bed to work with. All right, step number two, because you just moisturized your nails and you made your nail bed full of lotion and stuff like that, you've got to remove all of that so that the nail polish can adhere to your nail. So what I use is dehydrator. It's very inexpensive. It's just a product that basically removes all of the wetness from your nail and helps the polish adhere to it once you're ready to apply your manicure. I've never done this before, but I know that some people use isopropyl rubbing alcohol just to do that same thing. It's not intended for nails, and I personally prefer to use products that are intended for nails, but if that works for you, you do you, you know what I'm saying? All right, step number three is to use base coat. When I first started, I did not use base coat all the time, but I will tell you that it makes a huge difference. It makes your nail polish last longer, it protects your natural nail from staining, and in a lot of cases, if you're using a base coat that has like strengtheners in it, then you're actually helping your nails while you're painting them. So definitely make sure you get that base coat on there before you start painting anything else on. All right, so step four, we're gonna start actually doing the manicure. I know it takes a long time, but once you get the hang of all of these steps, it goes really quickly, I promise. So the way that I apply nail polish, I don't just dig in and start painting. There's a few little tricks to it. So when you're painting your nails, you wanna get a little tiny bit of nail polish on the brush. And the way that I do that is I'll open it up and then I'll swirl the brush around the neck of the bottle to like get any excess off. And then I'll wipe off both sides of the brush. And then I just dip it in, wipe one side again, and then you have a little bead of nail polish on one side of the brush. So that's what I use to paint my nail, and that's how I do each nail. Step number five is apply your nail polish in as few strokes as possible. Technically, the way that you're supposed to do it, which I don't really do, is you're supposed to take your polish, put it in sort of the center top of your nail, push up, and then swipe that down. Swipe once on the left, swipe once on the right, and then you're done. But we're not all perfect like that. So what I try to do is I try to start at the base of the nail right by my cuticle and then just start working my way up. I try to do as few strokes as possible, but sometimes you just need to even it out a little bit and make sure that there's the same amount of nail polish across your whole nail. Okay, this next step is probably the most important because I feel like a lot of people think that I'm just perfect at painting nails, that it's just like so easy and that they're never gonna get that because they don't have a steady hand or whatever, but that is not at all true. I clean up my manicures and that is is the way to get a nice looking manicure. You gotta clean it up after. I have a whole video on how to do it if you guys need extra tips and tricks, but basically the gist of it is I take some acetone, pure acetone, and I dip a little concealer brush in it. I use this dollar concealer brush from e.l.f., although I think they actually raised the price, which is annoying, but whatever. And then I just go around my cuticle area to clean that up, make a really clean, beautiful line, and then that's how you make it look like you did a really awesome manicure. All right, so step number 7 is apply your top coat. So I like to use quick dry top coats. That is the most important thing to me. If you use a quick dry top coat, you don't need your nail polish to fully dry underneath. I think a lot of people have this question. They're always asking me, I should just give you this information now, by the way. I wait usually a minute or two in between doing nail polish coats. So the way that I do it is I'll do my base coat and then pretty much immediately we'll do my first coat, wait about a minute, do my second coat, and then put on my top coat after another minute or so, because you don't need the nail polish underneath to be fully dry, because top coat will permeate through all those layers and it'll dry all of it. So I know a lot of people are always just like, I don't understand, my nail polish takes hours to dry. That's because you're not using a quick dry top coat. I would probably never use a regular top coat that wasn't advertised as a quick dry, because otherwise your nail polish is just never gonna dry. Another thing about top coat is a lot of people will wrap the tips, meaning that they'll go perpendicular to the nail and just swipe across on that actual little tip of the nail. Supposedly what that does is it'll seal in the manicure and it'll make it last longer. I personally don't do that. My nails are so short that if I do that, I'm just painting my skin. So if your nails are long enough, you can totally do it. If not, it's fine, because my nail polish still lasts a pretty long time, even though I don't wrap the tip. All right, we're on the last step. Step number 8 is to moisturize again. So after you use that acetone and clean up your nails, you have a little bit on your skin and it's looking a little dry. So you just wanna go ahead and moisturize your nails, rub that into your cuticles, make it look all nice, and then you have your salon quality manicure. Yay! Honestly, I think that once you get the hang of doing it by yourself, it's so much better than a salon manicure, even though I understand like a lot of people like to get pampered and go to the salon and stuff. I feel like this is just like a self-care activity and it's a lot of fun to do by myself. All right, so that's it. I know you guys are gonna ask, so I'm just gonna say it real quick. Usually from start to finish, doing a manicure for me is about 15 minutes and then another 5 minutes of just letting it dry, so probably around 20 minutes in total. Obviously, when you're just getting started, you're probably gonna go a little bit slower on painting those coats on doing your cleanup, but over time, it does get a lot easier. So yeah, hope this video was helpful for you guys. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you have any other requests for Nail Polish 101 videos, let me know. Like I said, I am doing a cuticle care videos, so that'll be coming out very soon. Give this video a thumbs up if you like my Nail Polish 101 videos, and if you're not already subscribed to my channel, you should subscribe. Blah, blah, blah. You should subscribe is what I meant to say. Sometimes you just say something so often that it just... Alright, that's it. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye! Oh, you know what's a fun fact? I actually, just with my friend the other weekend, we went out and we like pretended to be models for the day and we took a bunch of pictures with each other, and it was so much fun. I felt like an Insta model. Doing my poses and stuff like that, and they were bad, believe me. But I got a few good pictures, so if you guys are interested in seeing them, I've been posting a little bit on Instagram. So my Instagram is KELLI MARISSA if you guys are interested in seeing that. All right, talk to you later. Bye!